One skater left here in the men's free skate. It's Timothy Goebel getting ready on the ice along with his coach Frank Carroll. He tells us he's just now beginning to tap into his potential.
I don't feel that I've reached the limit of what I can do in this sport. I want to always continue to push myself, and I wanted to set new records and land new things and try new things, and pushing the envelope is something that motivates me. No one expected me ever to go and land three quads. I mean, I talked about doing it in practice. No one really believed I would do it. Most people thought I was crazy. Here we are, you know, 3 years after I did it the first time, and it got me an Olympic medal. And I think that that motivation, that drive to try new things keeps my skating fresh. For me, at this point, bronze is as good as gold. I mean, I really didn't expect any medal at all. To go to my first Olympics and be able to hold myself together as well as I did was an accomplishment in and of itself. Things are a little different now. A lot more people are coming just to watch me practice on a daily basis. Things aren't any harder, I don't think, but they certainly aren't any easier. I mean, now people watch everything that I do, and you know, if I go and don't skate as well at Worlds, then people are gonna say, oh, you know, it was a fluke. This year I've really done a lot to improve my skating and improve my artistry. I think people, especially after Olympics, are really noticing the improvements. A lot of people were complaining to myself and Frank that they didn't feel my artistic marks were high enough. I think once you're labeled, I think the media and I think sometimes the judges are too quick to label someone. The essence of me staying in for the next 4 years is that everything will improve. I will become a better jumper, that I will become more consistent, that I will become an artist on the ice as well as an athlete. This is only the beginning, really. I think that there's a lot more than I can expect out of myself.
Also representing USA, Timothy Goebel.
Well, the move from Cleveland to LA after placing 11th at the 2000 Worlds in order to work with Frank Carroll was critical. Now he's in a position to medal for the first time at the World Championships. Here's Timothy Goebel. Can't win the gold, but certainly can stand on that second step of the podium next to Yagudin.
Very easy start to a program. Triple Lutz. Where he is superb is the spinning ability in the air. Look at this quadruple salchow. Double toe loop. Spread eagle. A little bit of a jingle there on the ice. Must have caught an edge there, and it upset him in the edge going into the triple axel, which caused that bobble. You could see the wiggle on it as it stepped before he stepped into it. His tie down, and I think he's gonna find it all over in the next 2 minutes.
There have been some costume problems in this World Championship.
There always are.
Goebel came in not exactly 100%. He was battling bronchitis, but until this free skate, it didn't seem to bother him.
Combination spin. He's too much up on the toe. That's a better position than he's had in the past. Good back cross foot. And notice that it's halfway through the program, more than halfway through the program. He has wonderful energy, great stamina. Triple flip. Straight line footwork.
Goebel has to overtake Takeshi Honda and or Alexander Abt. Honda leads Abt right now, but remember, those rankings can flip.
Good back position. Much better than what he was doing a year ago, and a good back crossfoot spin, too, with the hands over the head. Well, there are a lot of good elements in that program, a couple of little flips here and there, but the program infinitely better than he's been doing in the past years. American in Paris, a wonderful choice. Lori Nickel, a fine choreographer.
Nice hand from Alexei Yagudin, too. And Timothy Goebel in third place after the short program wasn't enough to stand on the podium. We'll find out when we come back to the World Championships. Four-time world champion. Uh-oh, he's one away from Dick Button. He's gaining.
He's a lot more away in quadruple jumps, I'll tell you that.
But who's going to stand on the podium with him? Will Timothy Goebel be one of those?
Now, he started off the program with a magnificent quadruple salchow. Look at this turn back inside edge and the complete four revolutions right there in a perfect landing position as he stepped up into a double toe loop. But here, on this spread eagle, right there, you could see him catch an edge on the ice. It caused a bobble. It may have given him a little bit of a disruption as he settled into this triple axel. And our slow motion, brought to you by Chevy, shows that triple axel. Look here as he steps on the forward outside edge. The axel, remember, is the only jump that takes off on a forward edge. Gets good height, good arc. Right here at the end, you see the wildness of the free leg passing around, and that caused the problem.
Frank Carroll has been such a big part of Timothy Goebel's success over the past year and a half. They saw the eyes light up when they saw the technical merit marks in that 5.9 from the Ukrainian judge.
Well, they're nice. They respect the fact of his brilliant ability to perform quadruples, and I think that's what they're saying here.
The bronze medalist, Dick, from the Olympics, trying to medal here. Yeah, those are plenty hot.
Well, the presentation marks are really what they're saying about the improvement of this skater, and that's the interesting part.
Almost all second places from the judges, just one third, and Timothy Goebel captures his first medal at the World Championships, and it is a silver medal. But there's the gold medalist, no question about it, throughout this entire championship. Alexei Yagudin wins gold, but Goebel wins the silver.